Hi, this is Polyvent Teachers and I am Sagarika Banerjee. Once again, I am back with another exciting video of English language. Today, I will be taking up the topic tenses. This is part 3 of the topic tenses. So, without wasting much of the time, let me just begin my class today. And yes, please watch the video till the end. Part 3 of tenses. So let me share the screen with you all. So tenses part 3. Let's see what we have in store for you. So here we will read about past tenses. In the previous video, I taught you about present tense. Here we will read about past tense. So past tense is also divided into 4 categories, 4 different types. First is simple past tense. So how and where simple past tense is used and for what purpose it is used. Let's see. The simple past is used to indicate an action completed in the past. It often occurs with adverbs or adverb phrases of past time. So basically, simple past tense is used to indicate an action which is completed in the past, and it often occurs with adverbs or adverb phrases of past time. For example, the steamer sailed yesterday, adverb of past time. I received his letter a week ago. Again, a week ago is adverb of past time, adverb phrases of past time. She left school last year. So in all these 3 sentences, you can see the verbs used, sailed, received and left. These are the verbs which come under the second form of verb. That is the past form of verb. Simple past tense can also be used in the cases like sometimes this tense is used without an adverb of time. In such cases, the time may be either implied or indicated by the context. For example, I learned Hindi in Nagpur. I didn't sleep well. That means last night. Babur defeated Rana Sangha at Kanwaha. So, in all these 3 sentences, we can see the verbs are used in the simple past, that is second form of verb, but without an adverb of time. In third point, we learned that the simple past is used for past habits. Like in present tense, we read simple present was used in the cases of habitual action. In the case of simple past, we use it for past habits. For example, he studied many hours every day. So earlier he used to study many hours every day. Now he doesn't do. Or maybe he still continued. She always carried an umbrella. So this was the past habit. Next category of past tense is past continuous tense. The past continuous is used to denote an action going on at some time in the past. The time of action may or may not be indicated. So any action which you were doing or which somebody else was doing in the past time, at some time before, and the progressive action is being depicted. But we need to understand that it was done in the past. So past continuous is used. We were listening to the radio all evening. It was getting darker. The light went out while I was reading. When I saw him, he was playing chess. So in all these 4 sentences, if you can see, verbs are used, main verbs are used along with the supporting verb, were or was. These are the 2 supporting verbs which we have to use in past continuous tense. And when we are using it in the past continuous tense, we need to understand that we have to write the ing form of the verb. Listen becomes listening. As in the last 2 examples above, the past continuous and simple past are used together when a new action happened in the middle of a longer action. The simple past is used for the new action. Now, if you can see here, When I saw him, he was playing chess. So saw is the verb which is actually used in simple past. This is the simple past form. And he was playing is the past continuous form. So as in the last two examples above, the past continuous and simple past are used together when a new action happened in the middle of a longer action. The simple past is used for the new action. That means if you can see, it was a longer action. I saw him and he was playing chess. He was playing chess was a longer action. And simple past, I saw him, is the new action, because that he was playing was a longer action and he was playing for a longer time and then I saw him. Similarly, in the third sentence, the light went out while I was reading. So I was reading for a longer time. This is a longer time action. But light went out, it is the new action. This tense is also used with always and continually, etc. for persistent habits in the past. For example, he was always grumbling. So if any habit which is continuously being repeated, then you can use always in this past continuous tense. Next, third form of past tense is past perfect tense. What happens in this? The past perfect tense describes an action completed before a certain moment in the past. For example, I met him in New Delhi in 1996. I had seen him last 5 years before. So I met him in New Delhi 1996. I had seen him last 5 years before. Means the action completed before a certain moment in the past. So one more thing we need to understand in case of past perfect tense, if there are two actions happened in the past, it may be necessary to show which action happened earlier than the other. The past perfect is mainly used in such situations. The simple past is used in one clause and the past perfect is used in the other. Now here I would like to add one more point, that the past perfect tense is used with the action which happened earlier. And the new action, in case of new action, we use the simple past. For example, when I reached the station, the train had started. So the starting of the train had already happened. So it is the past action, earlier action. I reached the station late. So when I was, it is, I reached the station is the second action. The action which happened after the train started. So when I reached the station, the train started. So I couldn't get into the train. This is the gist. I had done my exercise when Hari came to see me. So Hari came to see me was after I had done my exercise. So the two actions are going on. First action was I had done my exercise. And then the second action is Hari came to see me. Next is I had written the letter before he arrived. Similar is the case. My writing of the letter was done before the other person arrived. Last type of past tense is past perfect continuous tense. The past perfect continuous is used for an action that began before a certain point in the past and continued up to that time. For example, at that time, I had been writing a novel for 2 months. Okay, when Mr. Mukherjee came to the school in 1995, Mr. Anand had already been teaching there for 5 years. So this is used for an action that began before a certain point in the past and continued up to that time when the action took place. Means, if we see the second sentence, when Mr. Mukherjee came to the school in 1995, he came to the school in 1995. And what he saw, that Mr. Anand had already been teaching there for 5 years. So this was the action that had began before his arrival, before the arrival of Mr. Mukherjee in the school. Now let's do one exercise. Choose the correct form, verb form, from those given in the brackets. So let's see, there are certain verbs given in the brackets. We have to choose the correct one and fill up the blanks. The earth dashed round the sun. And the options are move, moves, moved. Yes, the correct answer is moves. Let's see. My friends dashed the prime minister yesterday. See, have seen, saw. Let's see the correct answer. My friends dashed the prime minister yesterday. Saw. Yes. I dash him only one letter up to now. Sent, have sent, send. So I dash him only one letter up to now. I have sent. She dash worried about something. She looks worried or she is looking worried. Both are correct. Next sentence. It started to rain while we dash tennis. Are playing, were playing, had played. It should be were playing. He dashed fast when the accident happened. He is driving, was driving, drove. He was driving fast. He dashed asleep while he was driving. He fell asleep. I am sure I dashed him at the party last night. I am sure I saw him at the party last night. He dashed a mill in this town. He has a mill in this town. He dashed here for the last 5 years. He has been working for the last 5 years. He thanked me for what I had done. I dashed a strange noise. I hear a strange noise. I dash him for a long time. I have known him for a long time. I dash English for 5 years. I have been studying English for 5 years. Don't disturb me. I dash my homework. I am doing my homework. Abdul dash to be a doctor. Abdul wants to be a doctor. The soup dashed good. The soup tastes good. He dashed TV most evening. He watches TV most evenings. He dashed out 5 minutes ago. He went out 5 minutes ago. When he lived in Hyderabad, he dashed to the cinema once a week. When he lived in Hyderabad, he went to the cinema once a week. I dash something burning. I smell something burning. Look, the sun dash over the hills. Look, the sun is rising over the hills. She dashed unconscious since 4 o'clock. She has been unconscious since 4 o'clock. He used to visit us every week, but he dashed now. But he rarely comes now. We dashed for his call since 4:20. We have been waiting for his call since 4:20. She jumped off the bus while it was moving. When we went to the cinema, the film had already started. I dashed for half an hour when it suddenly started to rain. Have walked, have been walking, had been walking. I had been walking. Did you think you dashed me somewhere before? Did you think you had seen me somewhere before? The town dashed its appearance completely since 1980. The town has changed its appearance completely since 1920. Thank you for watching this video. That's all for today. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe my channel, that is hashtag PolyBenTeachers. And yes, do not forget to click on the bell icon so that you get the notifications of all my latest videos. Till I bring more videos,